Hello everyone, and in this video, I will be walking you through a new open source project, which is Waypoint. So Waypoint is a new open source tool announced by HashiCorp at HashiConf, and it is basically aimed to solve the three problems in the developer's workflow, which is build, deploy, and release. So before diving into the demo and the concepts, there is a prerequisite that we should be having a K3s cluster because that's where the demo is all about. So I will create a Civo Kubernetes K3s cluster, managed K3s service. So with a simple command, Civo K3s create --wait --save so that it's get the kubeconfig gets saved. And then we can switch the context and use it. Also for the installation part, I already have Waypoint installed. Now what you can do is, we will see there are other ways where you can download Waypoint. So you can go to waypointproject.io/downloads, and you can see on Mac, I have installed it this way. If you have other operating systems, you can readily install them. The commands are fairly, very simple and on different flavors as well. They are mentioned. So let's see what actually Waypoint is. So Waypoint actually is a tool that enables the developers to get their applications from development to the production environment in using a single file and a single command called Waypoint up. Now what that means is, say that it's basically code to cloud or code to Kubernetes or code to platform. So you directly have a one file, which is called the HCL file that I'll be walking you through. But there's a single file and you don't have to learn any of the other stuff, like any of the other tooling which are required, which will be different for different platforms, different CLIs for different platforms, and different ways to deploy to different platforms. So you can use single way to deploy to platforms and keep it consistent over all the platforms. So that's what they have mentioned in the Waypoint goals as well, like the consistency in workflows, confidence in the deployment. And by confident deployment, you have different tools like Waypoint logs and Waypoint exec to view the logs of the deployment and exec into the container and see different things for debugging purposes. And it comes with a very extensible UI, and it's actually the Waypoint tool itself is extendable using the plugins that I'll be showing you. Now that the thing I was telling you, like Waypoint was built to provide ease of use and you don't need to write Docker files and YAML files, and it is consistent across the platform. That is actually the reason why Waypoint was created, so that you don't have to deal with all the complexities of writing the YAMLs, learning the tools for different platform, different tools, different serverless infrastructures, then different tools. So all these things remains the same. And so I was telling you about the plugins. So Waypoint have different plugins, and these plugins are actually what forms the waypoint.hcl file for the particular project that you want to deploy. Now you have mainly we'll be using Docker plugins or Docker. So there is a build, deploy, and a release step. So we'll be using a builder Docker in our scenario, but there are other builders like the build packs as well. So you can have Docker as a builder and as a platform as well. So you can see, go down, you can have as a platform as well. Now Kubernetes, on the other hand, only comes as a platform because it doesn't build the images. But for the builders part, you can use Docker and cloud native or cloud native build packs. And HashiCorp used cloud native build packs as a very good use case. So in their tutorial, I think it's the cloud native build packs that is mentioned. The repository wise, we'll be using this particular repo. And this is a Waypoint demo. And this is the main file that we have to create and go through. So you can see we have a project called Saiyam Waypoint. Then we give specific instructions for that. So we create an app with labels and the service name and the environment. The most important part is just this: build, deploy, release. So we are using Docker. And we have given the image name and tag that we want to push and use inside our Kubernetes environment. Now we give deploy. So where we want to deploy, here is the platform that I was showing you. So you have so we have given here Kubernetes, and this is a readiness probe and the service port. And the release part, again, we are using Kubernetes and we have defined the node ports and so on for the service. So you don't have to write all the namespaces, like all the deployment big file and the service big file. And it can be more complex as well. This is just a simple example. Let's see if our cluster has been created. Okay, so our cluster is created. And what we'll do is we'll do a Waypoint install. So we'll install the Waypoint service and the stateful set onto the Kubernetes platform. But before doing that, first let's switch the context. And we should be able to kubectl get nodes. All are in ready state. And now the cluster resources will get created. So it has created the service and the stateful set. And on this side, what we can do is kubectl get pods -a, and we can see the stateful set should be in container creating state, which is exactly the case. And I have is I'm already inside the repo, the git clone repo, and I already have a waypoint.hcl file. So what we'll do, so the waypoint UI is already deployed. We can see that. Let's see. Waypoint comes with a beautiful UI. So we can see the Waypoint UI is there. And okay, let's authenticate. We can do the authentication. We can log in using this token. So we don't have anything yet. So what we'll do is we come here, we do Waypoint init. It will check for the configuration files, which is there, and it will be seeing that the project is initialized. Now there is a single command, waypoint up. Now it will start performing all the steps that we have defined inside the waypoint.hcl file. So you can see that building the image. So it already used all the caches because I already have those images in pulled locally. So it is using the images from the cache, and all the other steps it is trying to do. Then it is pushing. Again, the image is already there in my Docker Hub account, and it is pushing in the name of Saiyam911/cd-demo. And then after the build step is completed, now comes the deploy part. Now in the deploy part, what it's trying to do is the client is getting created, connected, and then it is trying to create a deployment out of the image that I have provided. So if we come back here, we try to do kubectl get pods, we should be able to say something in container creating state, which is our application. So this is our application that it is trying to create. And if we go back to the UI, we see the project is already there. If we go to the project, this is the application. If you go to the application, you can see the build is already successful. The deployments is in progress. And once the deployment is there, we'll be able to see the logs as well. So we can just go back and see it is waiting for it to be available. And we can just try to do kubectl get pods again. It's running, so it's just checking the readiness probe now. And we can also see the SVCs, the service. And you can see the service is there 1 second ago. So I think it passed and it has deployed. Yes. So once the service is after getting ready, so it creates a service. So deployment was successful and it is already deployed, and we can easily see the application. Now let's see actually the application, and we can see the logs as well on the UI. So what we'll do is we'll just remove this 9702 and we'll go to the application and see that the application is running. So it's HTTP. Awesome. So the application is up and running. So hello all. Here it is. So that was a simple application, simple code to Civo K3S Kubernetes. The application is already deployed and I didn't write any YAML code. I didn't do anything. So that's how simple it is to deploy an application directly to the Kubernetes using just your code and a simple file. in a matter of minutes. So that's how simple Waypoint is. And if we want to see additional things like Waypoint logs, Waypoint logs. So it will give you the logs that you are able to see. And we can also do Waypoint exec. So this will exec into the container and do a ls command over there. So you can see all the files that are present. So this way, this is helpful for debugging, and even the UI is helpful for debugging. So if we go back to the UI, even that is helpful for debugging purposes. So you can see here, and you can do the exec. So you can see the releases, the builds, and you can also see all the build steps that happened. So whatever the build logs were present over there, they'll be stored here as well. So that was in a nutshell what Waypoint is. I also have a blog written where I have explained the end-to-end demo. So if anybody is interested in reading and doing, you can use this blog as well. All the links will be put in the description. And thank you for watching.